definitely made a difference.
I'm more confident.
My Connections Academy teachers inspired me so much, I became one myself.
I better read faster.
Connections Academy, the tuition-free online public school for grades K through 12. Visit connectionsacademy.com.
Your teams all the time. New York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Have taken the field for tonight's game as Logan Williamson goes through his warm-ups. The Bluefish lineup brought to you by Flying Feet. It'll be Brian Sabatella in left field leading things off. Josh Prince, the second baseman, bats second. Hitting third, the league leader in batting, Wellington Dotel. He's in right field. CJ Rutherford, just added to their team, will DH and bat cleanup. Andres Rodriguez, the first baseman, hits fifth. Wilson Batista at third base will bat sixth. Matt Wessinger, the shortstop, is hitting seventh tonight. Luis Rodriguez will do the catching and bat eighth. And Ethan Chapman in center field hits ninth. Again, it's Sabatella, Prince, Dotel, Rutherford, Rodriguez, Batista, Wessinger, Rodriguez, and Chapman for the Bluefish. That lineup facing Logan Williamson, who's 7-11 coming in tonight, trying to snap a two-game skid. He is ranked 10th in the league in ERA at 3.88. 130 innings, 136 hits, opponents batting 271. He has walked 54 while striking out 71. The Bluefish, a team that he's had a little bit of trouble against. One win, but maybe his roughest outing of the year was in Bridgeport on the 4th of July, but he did come back and beat them a little over a month later in Bridgeport. 6 1/3, 4 runs, 3 earned, and a 13-5 win. He's set to go tonight. The All-Star from earlier this season, Revs in their home whites. Bridgeport in alternate jerseys with navy on the front, teal in the back, and the word fish across the front as Sabatella stands in an overcast and warm and muggy evening here at the ballpark as Williamson gathers himself behind the mound and ready to work. And tonight's Dasher Investment Services first pitch on the way. It is right there for a called strike, and that'll get us started. 6:37, our first pitch time tonight. Sabatella hitting at 277. 0-1, it is off the plate away. He began the year with Long Island, got off to a great start. Big piece of their offense that put up some impressive numbers. Williamson missing inside, 2-1. That then kind of tailed off, and when Phelan Lentini returned to the Ducks, they traded Sabatella for Sean Burroughs, as Williamson misses down and in, 3-1. This is his 25th game played with the Bluefish tonight. There's the wind, and Williamson the pitch. And a swing and a fly ball in center. James Simmons, the former Bluefish, lines it up and inches over toward right center, puts it away. One up, one down. Our plate ump tonight is Warren Nicholson, John Harrington at first, Fred DeJesus, the umpire, at third base. Our game time temp tonight on our board in left center, 84 degrees. It was mid-90s earlier today before that rain shower came through and brought cloud cover with it. Here's Josh Prince, who takes up high. Prince hitting at 266. Has 3 home runs, 14 driven in. Now the 1-0, and that misses down. Williamson's last outing, 6-plus. At Somerset, 6 runs, a 6-4 loss on Saturday night. The 2-0, and that's over for a strike. He retired his first eight. He was off to a great start, but with two outs in the third, allowed four runs. That was the big inning. Here's a swing and a ground ball to shortstop. Oh, Valdez mishandles, picks up, fires, still in time. Prince had given up on it, assuming the out, and it hit the heel of Valdez mitt, but able to recover and fire it across. Prince tried to pick it up a gear, but it was too late. No, Valdez gets away with one. And with two down, the base is empty as Wellington Dotel makes his way to the plate. Leading the league in hitting, and it's not close. 337 is his average. Leads in total hits, steals, a bunch of other categories that go with it as Williamson delivers a strike. Total bases, extra base hits, slugging percentage. He's got seven home runs, and he swings and misses, golfing at one in the dirt. No balls, two strikes. Next closest hitter is Long Island's Delta Cleary Jr., 28 points behind, 309. So Dotel running away with the batting title. The 0-2. And he bounces one toward third and foul, pounds across the line to glove it. This is the second of only two series in York between these two this season. Williamson kicks and delivers. Swing and a miss. Got him on a slider and works a 1-2-3. Top of the first. Good start for Williamson at the end of a half inning. It's the Bluefish nothing. The Revs coming up.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this is sounding just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles. Whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both, it is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com.
Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats. A savings of 25% over box office prices, plus 10 bucks in free food, so head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
An invasive pest that's already killed millions of ash trees is bearing down on our communities. The emerald ash borer, or EAB, means certain death for every ash tree it infects. The good news is that you can protect your property's ash trees with help from Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. Our EAB prevention methods are effective, environmentally safe, and less costly than removing your dead tree, which is the only alternative to prevention. Learn more at heritagelawnandlandscape.com.
All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
No score with the Revs coming to bat. Bottom of the first. Lineup tonight brought to you by Flying Feet. Eric Patterson will lead off and play second base. Wilson Valdez, the shortstop, hits second. Batting third and DHing is Andres Perez. It'll be Brandon Boggs in right field in the cleanup spot. Brian Pounds at third base hits fifth. Talvin Nash, the first baseman, batting sixth. And it's Salvador Paniagua catching, Nick Ferdinand the start in left, and James Simmons is in center. Again, Patterson, Valdez, Perez, Boggs, Pounds, Nash, Paniagua, Ferdinand, and Simmons. Facing Bridgeport lefty Brandon Bixler, 5'11 lefty, just 23 years of age. And he'll step into his windup. First pitch of his night is over for a strike on Patterson. Bixler, a former farmhand of the Twins. A little bit different delivery as he deals home. And a breaking ball hooks low for Patterson. He leads off for the third time this season. Back in 2013, he was a regular leadoff hitter for the team. The 1-1, that's down and away. Comes in hitting at 248. Has batted 288 his last 23 games played. Now the 2-1. And a line drive the other way. Base hit to start the night. This will two-hop the base of the wall. He's going to try it. Sabatella the throw. He's out at second base. Trying to stretch it into a double. And Sabatella throws him out. The elation of a leadoff hit to start the night, followed by the frustration of being thrown out. Well, looking to spark things, he was looking to turn it into extra bases, but it was hit so hard and Sabatella got a hard carom off the base of the wall, so he didn't have to rush much. Able to take his time, make a good one-hop throw. Here's Wilson Valdez. First offering is down and away. Still, though, good to see solid contact made to start the evening. Now the wind and the 1-0. And that misses low. And Bixler has a little hitch with his hands as he separates, and then he points his glove hand basically straight upward. He deals and misses high, 3-0. Kind of a slow arm swing. Slow to his landing spot, then tries to whip it all through. The 3-0. And a missed inside. He walks Valdez on four pitches. So officially, each of the Revs' first two batters have reached. Here's Andres Perez, who's homered in back-to-back games. Last night, he clobbered his 50th home run all-time with York, and the second in Revs history to reach that mark. Chris Noack hit 59, the team record. And Bixler's first pitch is over for a strike. Now to the stretch, he has that same long, drawn-out glove hand to the sky motion. Be interesting to see how he can control a running game tonight as Perez swings and pulls a ground foul off the front of the Bluefish dugout. I don't know if he can have that same glove action and still go over to first. I would think that'd be difficult. Pretty committed to home plate if he's going to do all that. Valdez the lead. And he deals and misses high with it. He does go out of a slide step on that pitch. It does seem a little long and drawn out. Time asked for. Then again, he's got one of the greatest throwing catchers in league history behind the plate, Luis Rodriguez, to help him out. Here's the stretch, and a move to first base. Valdez back standing. He's fourth in the league in steals with 30. Perez entering the night, leading the league in RBIs by two with 72. Bixler, the 1-2, Valdez running, and Perez fouls it back into the screen. Valdez had a good jump on that pitch. That home run last night for Dre, his 11th since the middle of July, so basically 11 in the second half after 3 in the first. Dexler stares him down, delivers home, and a breaking ball low and in, blocked by Rodriguez, 2-2. Perez, 7th in the league in batting at .289, 14 home runs, is tied for 4th. And now a move to first. Valdez was running. Throw down from first base. And that's in time. 1-3-6 on a caught stealing. Rodriguez relaying it to Wessinger. And the Revs have made two outs at second base here in this first inning. And he did have that glove reach. But, I mean, really, it is about the legwork. And I guess he didn't cross the plane. Pitch to Perez, a curveball and missed high. It's a full count. I don't know how he'd be able to throw to first or keep the runners honest. Valdez went on first move, but as long as the leg doesn't come back, you can still throw over. Pitch to Dre is high and away, and he walks. Each of the three batters so far have reached base. And yet, with two outs, Dre is the only one standing down there safely. No score here in the bottom of the first inning. A single now followed by back-to-back walks. Well, here's Brandon Boggs. Batting .319 against lefties, .266 overall. First pitch is swung on and belted. Deep left field, it is gone! Brandon Boggs, a line drive, two-run homer. Out over the arch nemesis in left. First pitch swinging, and the Revs jump in front, 2-0 here in the bottom of the first. His 11th of the year. And had they been a little more cautious on the bases, it might have been a slam, but it's a 2-0 first inning lead as Boggs leaves the park. Here's Brian Pounds as he takes a strike. A line drive, he connected on it, and it cleared the big wall. It's Boggs' 7th in just over a month, his 11th of the season. Pitch to Pounds is down and away. So we've got a winner on our Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care home run contest tonight already. Here's the wind and the pitch. And a swing and a pop foul out of play. First base side. Mike Pearl is our winner tonight. Congratulations, Mike. Stop by the Apple Chevrolet ticket office during normal business hours. At your convenience, and you can claim your prize pack from the Revs and Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. The wind, the pitch to Pounds, and a swing and a fly ball foul the other way. This will carry up into the picnic area and land right amongst the band equipment. Battle of the bands tonight. Bixler delivers. And a fastball missed away. Good eye. Pounds is 4th in the league and on base, 5th in slugging. He's in the top 5 in both. Overall batting at .275. On the wind and the 2-2. Swing and a miss. A changeup gets him, and that'll end the inning. But the Revs, it could have been more, but they jump in front on Boggs' 2-run homer. 2 hits in the inning. Nobody left. We go to the second. It's York 2, Bridgeport nothing.
Broadway transmission. I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our ATRA certified technicians.
Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they helped me with financing. Still with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA-approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
WellSpan has helped many professionals, student, and recreational athletes stay at the top of their game. And they can do the same for you. Our winning team offers everything from concussion management and sports nutrition to physical therapy and more. For more information, call 877-482-5420 or visit wellspan.org/sportsmedicine.
For local sports on your smartphone, search WOIK at the App Store.
Two nothing lead, courtesy of Brandon Boggs, 11th of the year, as he goes deep against his former team, and Logan Williamson to start the second. First pitch is up and away on C.J. Rutherford. He leads off the inning, playing in his second game with Bridgeport. The 1-0, and that's on the outside corner for a strike. Rutherford 1-for-4 with a ribby thus far, DHing the night. Had been in Mexico. Pitch, and he swings and fouls one back. Now to play, it's a ball and two strikes. Rebs are second in the league in homers. That was their 88th that Boggs hit. Here's the 1-2. And it misses outside. Williamson trying his changeup. And a fly out, a ground out, and a K in the top of the first. Now time asked for by the hitter. The wind, the 2-2. Missed high and away, a full count. And the Revs could have had more in the first, but great to jump on top regardless. The wind, the payoff pitch, swung on, slapped to first. Talvin Nash had it bounce off his glove, and then Patterson overruns it. As it comes to a stop on the infield dirt, it'll be an error on Nash at first base. He was right there. He jumped half a step to his right, and on a sharply hit ball, looked like he was going to make a nice play to get in front of it, but glanced off his glove. He was right there and thought he had it for a moment, but skipped over toward Patterson, who charged hard to his left, didn't have much of a chance at that point, and couldn't get the initial pickup either. Here's Andres Rodriguez now, and Williamson pours a strike in at the knees. Rodriguez hitting at 237, but here lately, much hotter than that, the last 10 games, 366. The 0-1, and he nubs one foul to the right of home plate. Barely got a piece of that. Nothing in two. Rodriguez has some pop. He's got 6 home runs for the year. Throw to first base, Rutherford back standing. Oh. Rodriguez is complaining about the the signs in the outfield. The stretch from Williamson. And the 0-2 fastball just missed, down and in. Rodriguez came along with Ricky Van Asselberg, first-year manager with Bridgeport. He had played for him previously in the American Association. Big boy, 6'5", 260. Pitch from Logan is down low. And the count now 2-2. Been in Amarillo last season. Grand Prairie before that. Now the stretch. And the 2-2. Swing and a foul tip, straight back. Rodriguez just hangs in. Revs a 2-0 lead here in the top of the second. Leadoff runner on for the Bluefish. Williamson stares in, he's got it. And another 2-2 changeup ripped into left, a base hit. He left it over the plate. Rodriguez, who's been hot, hits it hard and yanks a single. So it's first and second, nobody out. We'll pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Revolution Radio.
First in York, first in sports. Your only local sports station. The new Sports Radio 1350, WOYK, York, Pennsylvania.
The two on, nobody out. Wilson Batista stands in. Bridgeport threatening to answer. And he swings and lines one to left for a hit. Toward the line, Ferdinand's got it. Guns it in quickly. They'll stop the lead runner, Rutherford, at third. And that'll load him with nobody out. Batista, first pitch swinging. And with Bridgeport, he is now 11 for 19 against York. He jumped on the first one and pulled it into left. And after the leadoff error, back-to-back singles have followed. One on a deep count, this one on a first pitch. Another loaded for Matt Wessinger. Revs will play a double play depth, of course. First offering missed away. Ball one. Wessinger hitting at 210. I think the big inning for Logan to avoid that is a key tonight. That's what plagued him the most in his last start. And the 1-0, fastball just missed. Close, but called inside. On the 2-0, and a tapper foul straight back, right over toward Luis Rodriguez, who's on deck. Wessinger had been named the K-man tonight. Williamson ready, and he'll step off. Now he's got his sign, the 2-1. Swinging a foul tip off the glove of Paniagua. Two balls, two strikes. Big at bat here. Just needs an out, even if a run scores on it. He's ready. The 2-2. Swung on and fouled. First base side and up on the roof. Try it once more. Kicks and fires. Change up, got him. Swing and a miss. A huge strikeout for out number one. Had to work for it, but Williamson wins the battle. And one away here in the top of the second. If he can command that pitch, it opens up a lot for him. And throwing it on 2-2 with the bases loaded. Don't really want to go to 3-2 with them loaded. He had the confidence to throw it there and got the K with it. Here's Luis Rodriguez, the catcher. First offering is just off away. Rodriguez hitting 219, but against York, 346. There's the 1-0, and a miss down low, off speed, and Williamson falls behind him, 2-0. Rodriguez, 41 years of age, still splitting catching duties, the 2-0. Swung on and driven deep to left field, gone, a grand slam. A line drive over the arch nemesis in left. And Bridgeport jumps in front, 4-2 here in the top of the second. Rodriguez with his second of the year. He has tormented the Revs, and that right there was his biggest hit of all against them this season. And it's now an early lead for Bridgeport. Perhaps if not for a couple of outs on the bases, Boggs' homer would have been a slam. Rodriguez indeed is. Here's Ethan Chapman. And Williamson back to the windup, misses down and away. Fifth grand slam hit against the Revs this season, the first since mid-July. Here's a ground ball slapped the other way and through, a base hit to left. And Chapman follows with a single. And unfortunately, the big inning has bitten Williamson again. So far, the damage on one swing. Opponents have hit five slams against York. The Revs, if you're wondering, have hit three. Here's Sabatella at the top of the order. Flew out to center his first time up. First pitch, fastball is a strike. Williamson had a close first pitch against Rodriguez that he didn't get. And then he missed with the next one, so he was behind 2-0, had to get one over the plate. And Rodriguez hit it out. Here's a ground ball to third. Pounds backhands it. Throws to second. Turn to first. Dug out. Picked out of the dirt by Telvin Nash. A sweet scoop. And it's a 5-4-3. Inning ending. Double play. Nicely done at both ends. And Patterson on the quick turn. But Bridgeport takes the lead. Four runs. Four hits, one error, nobody left. We go to the bottom of the second. It's the Bluefish 4, the Revs 2.
Maple Donuts knows that there comes a point in every kid's summer when the feeling of unfettered freedom begins to fold up faster than a picnic blanket at the first drop of an unexpected summer storm. Charlie and his Maple Donuts team understand that all too soon, lazy mornings on the sofa, splashing in the pool, and weeknight sleepovers will be replaced by bus stops, backpacks, and morning announcements. But Maple Donuts says there's a bright side to the first day of school, kids. Because when you stumble into the kitchen that first morning, chances are you'll be greeted by Mom, enjoying her cup of Maple Donuts' famous coffee and sitting next to a back-to-school tradition, a box of Maple Donuts. And somewhere buried in that box, handpicked by Mom from Maple Donuts' 58 varieties, you may find that, yes, summer is over, but another school year may not be so bad after all. So for every kid coming to grips with going back to school, we say thanks, Mom. And thank you, Maple Donuts.
Maple Donuts taste right. Joel's Painting and Contracting is a proud sponsor of the York Revolution. They are also a partner in the maintenance of Santander Stadium. Joel's Painting and Contracting is the highest rated painting company in York and Lancaster County. Now is the time to call for great deals on all your interior and exterior projects. A community partner with thousands of happy clients, hit a home run of Joel's Painting and schedule an appointment today or give them a call at 717-471-4273. That's 717-471-4273 for Joel's Painting and Contracting.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Four to two, Bridgeport in front. We go to the bottom of the second. Rebs will look to come back with their own answer as Talvin Nash leads things off. And Brandon Bixler into his windup. First pitch of the inning is slugged to left field. Sabatello, though, is there, tiptoeing back, and he's got it. That ball in on Nash just a bit, who got jammed. He still muscled it to the warning track and left, but Sabatello there to squeeze the liner. Salvador Paniagua up next. Bixler is making his sixth appearance, his third start. 0-1, a 3.07 ERA coming in. 14 and two-thirds innings, just nine hits. Five runs, three walks, 13 Ks. Opponents had hit 180 entering the night. Pitch to Paniagua is down and away. So good numbers coming in. The 1-0, and that's in the dirt. Paniagua hitting at 242, five home runs, two the other night. Against lefties, he's hit 304 with three of those five homers. The 2-0, that misses high. The wind is blowing right to left. That'll help the right-hand hitters tonight if they get one up. Pitch. It is up high. Four-pitch walk. Said Paniagua's on base. Hey, Matt, can you do me a favor? I had a Mountain Dew in the fridge in there. Matt's our man on the other side of the glass. Actually, two windows down. It's tough when you tweet and everything, you know, just very little time for refreshments. Here's Nick Ferdinand, and he checks his swing, fouls one back to the right of the net. He went and got it, too. Oh, man. Here's the 0-1. And a fastball over for a strike. Good to get Ferdinand an opportunity back in the lineup tonight. You actually went and did it. Thank you. Here's the 0-2. And a swing and a liner toward the corner and left. And that'll smack off the wall. Kicks away from Sabatella. Paniagua will motor all the way to third. Ferdinand's on with a wall ball single. Back in the lineup tonight, and he got some backspin on it, and it carried off the base of the arch nemesis on the fly. Rebs have been swinging it here against Bixler early on. That wall getting a wear out too. First and third, and here's James Simmons. Rebs trying to answer back, trailing 4-2 here early. And Bixler set, steals, and it's down low. Fastball at 90. He's not a total soft tossing lefty. So Simmons at 220 with a home run, 34 driven in, his combined numbers between York and Bridgeport. The 1-0, that's up high. He leaves it go, a changeup. Simmons, a nice night last night. He doubled, walked twice, scored a run. Bixler ready. The 2-0. Fastball, a smidge low. 3-0 with Patterson at the top of the order waiting on deck. Now he deals and taking all the way. That's over for a strike. Simmons, a tough go on the bases last night. Slipped in the seventh inning trying to get to third. I don't know if they faked him at second or what happened. Here's the 3-1. Swung on, ground and foul. Third base side. He's kind of had an on and off role in the lineup, and more often than not has done a very nice job. Celebrating his 30th birthday yesterday. Here's the stretch. Staring at first, the 3-2 swung on, grounded to short. Right there is Wessinger. He flips to second, and the turn to first is in time. Dead double play ball. He hit it sharply, but right at him. And as an infielder, that's exactly how you'd want it. No runs, one hit, and one left. We go to the third. Bridgeport still on top, 4-2.
Providing quality services efficiently and in a timely manner to its clients is the mission of the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins. GSLSC is equipped to handle any real estate transactions, leases, residential and commercial real estate settlements, zoning issues, and all matters involving municipalities. They are also experienced in the formation and operation of family real estate ventures that are tax sensitive to the needs of the investors. Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins is an approved title insurance agency and can provide you with title insurance and legal representation at one low cost when buying a home or investment property. Don't risk any real estate settlement without an experienced real estate attorney from the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins at your side. Phone 717-757-7602. They've been handling residential and commercial real estate matters in South Central Pennsylvania for more than 50 years. With mortgage interest rates at an all-time low, now is the time to buy or refinance. Phone 717-757-7602 today or visit their website, gslsc.com.
Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats. A savings of 25% over box office prices, plus 10 bucks in free food. So head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
York Sports on your mobile device or online at WOYK1350.com.
Head of the third, it's a 4-2 Bridgeport lead. And good evening, Paul.
I'm on a two-game homer streak.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
For us, I hope.
Yeah. Fourth and fifth inning. Last two times I was on. Fourth or fifth.
Revs are in a little bit of a rut, unfortunately, this week. As Josh Prince leads off the third inning, Williamson's first pitch, a breaking ball just missed away. They have dropped 4 of 5 coming in tonight. I know they certainly didn't draw up losing 2 of 3 to Camden. Pitch, it is off the plate away, 2-0. Now it'll be Lancaster hosting Camden this weekend.
Lancaster.
Here's the wind, the 2-0. And he got that one over, a changeup strike. Prince a ground out to short his first time up. 2, 3, and 4 in the order do. The 2-1 and a changeup missed away. Williamson also recently a bit of a rut himself. Back-to-back losses coming in. There's a fastball strike called. Prince took one step toward first. 3-2. Logan trying to get back in the win column tonight. The Revs as well with 17 remaining plus the suspended game. Here's a swing and a chopper towards short. Valdez charging hard. He gloves. He whips it on the run. And right on target to first. One away.
That suspended game in Southern Maryland. I mean, I'm just counting down the days until Telvin Nash can get his home run. He just has a home run floating out there in cyberspace that he hasn't gotten credit for yet.
He actually was a little surprised when I mentioned it to him, so I guess he doesn't
Wow.
He doesn't pay it that close of attention.
Well, I'm impressed.
Yeah.
You mean to tell me there's a guy that swings a bat that doesn't know what his exact stats are every day of every season?
Well, he assumed that he had five. He didn't realize it wasn't showing up.
Well, now see, now you tipped him off. Yeah. He's not going to be happy now.
1-0 on Dotel. And he swings and bounces one softly to third. That'll go foul. Dotel a strikeout swinging his first time up. The league leader in hitting by, at the moment, a runaway margin. 1-1 pitch, a fastball strike, inside corner at 89. Been a while since Williamson started here. He deals, and is swinging a little trickler foul behind the plate.
When's the last time Nick Ferdinand started at home?
Well, that's been a while, too.
Yeah.
Actually, 8 of Logan's last 9 had been started on the road.
Wow.
It's been a while. He fires and misses down low. He started at home July 14th, then 4 straight on the road. Then August 9th at home, and then 4 straight on the road. So it's his first home start in almost a month, and only his second in a little less than 2 months. There's a pitch up and in, and it'll be a full count to Dotel.
Well, after August 12th, the Revolution spent the entire month remaining, aside from 3 days on the road anyway, so.
Roller coaster of a schedule, the payoff pitch, and a bouncing ball toward the middle. Valdez will cut it off, lunging toward the bag at second. He fires on the run again, makes another nice play at short, 2 down in the inning. Well, again tonight, beginning our high school football game of the week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. If you are looking for that, Central at West York, it's on WOYK1350.com tonight. I'm glad that the storms have stayed away. They could have wreaked havoc on those games, too.
Let's play some football.
Here's a liner. Backhand grab at third. Pounds on the short hop. Throws to first. And C.J. Rutherford retired as Pounds makes a slick play. On the backhand with the glove, a short hop handled for the final out. 1-2-3, top of the third. We'll go to the home half. Revs still trail 4-2.
Whether it's for sport, protection, or recreation, Spar Firearms is the best place to go for all of your firearm needs. With a large selection of new and used firearms, Spar carries an array of brands, as well as ammo and other accessories. Whether you're an avid collector, sharpshooting expert, hunter, or weekend enthusiast, Spar Firearms provides everything you need, no matter your experience. For the best in convenience, selection, and customer service, visit Spar Firearms, 6108 Carlisle Pike in Mechanicsburg, and online at sparfirearms.com.
Turn this on.
The Rich Eisen Show.
He is unbelievable.
Rich Eisen.
Let's go to the phone lines. They are lit. Catherine in South Carolina, can I help you?
Yes, I am having emotional distress.
Don't.
I'm going to sue the Jones family.
Don't.
This is crazy. It's the most stupid, idiotic thing. The Jones are screwing this up. And I am sick. I've left work. I'm nauseous. He's strung us out. Time to DeMarco.
Well, what about the idea that anybody could run behind that offensive line? Catherine, you don't buy that one?
DeMarco is family. He and Tony and Jason do everything together. He's family. I just started to be a Cowboys fan again, and happiness has just plunged to despair. What the Jones has done to my emotional state, they should be sued.
Don't go litigious on me here, okay?
This is the Rich Eisen Show.
Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports. First in York, first in sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Two, Bridgeport on top. As we head to the bottom of the third, Eric Patterson to lead things off. Single to his first time up. It was interesting, sitting in Mace's office earlier, he had broken down the remaining schedule out of curiosity. It was Bixler's first pitch. It's high and tight. Between who York plays and who Lancaster plays, and the head-to-head records for the Revs and Barnstormers, respectively, against those teams, it comes out pretty even over what they've done so far this season. The 1-0, and a line drive at short, leaping grab by Matt Wessinger. Maybe not to the top rung of the ladder, but able to get up and bring it down. Patterson would have had a hit with a little more height. One down here in the third. More pretty good contact, even though it goes for an out. There's Wilson Valdez, who walked his first time up and was then caught stealing. On the pick over by Bixler. On the lefty, delivers and missed down low. On our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard, no score in the first. In Lancaster, Barnstormers batting, hosting Camden. Elsewhere, they're in the fourth. Long Island hosting Southern Maryland, leading 1-0. Somerset is at Sugar Land in about half an hour. The 1-0, and that's up high. Bixler from Florida. He deals, and that's down and in. Most recently at Cedar Rapids in the Twins system, he'd been as high as single A. On the wide and the 3-0, and that's high and tight. Four-pitch walk, his second four-pitch walk, and fourth walk total. Second time that he's walked Valdez.
Well, he doesn't exactly have textbook mechanics.
No.
I mean, his release point is so high that it's almost impossible for him to not miss high at least a couple times in a bat. And not every pitcher has to have textbook mechanics, but if not, you better have Clayton Kershaw stuff. And Steven Strasburg stuff.
Andres Perez, he swings first pitch and lofts a fly toward the line and right. A long run for Dotel. It'll land foul in the York bullpen.
Ubaldo Jimenez circa 2008 stuff.
You'd throw him up there too?
Well, the mechanics don't get attention until guys start getting hits off you or you start giving up walks. I mean, he just is way up above his ear releasing the ball and he tilts way back and I mean, there's a lot of arms and legs in his delivery. It kind of reminds me of Alan Quijano, but again, Quijano, very unconventional, but got guys out in this league. He's probably, you know, if not our best, our second-best starter last year.
Pitch on the way. Breaking ball tumbles in at the top of the zone for a strike. Yeah, it does remind you of that. He wasn't quite that drastic, though, with the glove lift and all that.
I mean, you don't want to mess too much with a guy's natural motion because then he's just going to outthink himself. But, I mean, it's really not a mystery why he leaves a lot of balls up.
He misses high and away there.
I mean, this guy, you make a mistake inside and up in the zone on the inner half of the plate to this guy, it's going to be a two-run homer.
There's the stretch. Stares at first. stairs. He'll deliver home, and a breaking ball. Strike three called. A late call, and Perez is rung up. And he's upset and holding his tongue as he walks away back to the dugout. Two down in the inning.
Well, I don't know if Perez felt that was outside, but I thought that was a pretty good pitch. We criticized him for a couple minutes there, and I thought that was a pretty good pitch.
Well, here's Brandon Boggs, who delivered a two-run homer in the bottom of the first, his 11th of the year.
I mean, if anything, it was outside because it wasn't high.
First offering here is lifted in the air and left. Sabatella's got it lined up, though. Over toward the line and actually comes in a step in front of the track and puts it away. Boggs didn't quite get extended on that swing. No runs, no hits, one left. Paul will have the call as we head to the fourth. Revs trail at the end of three, 4-2.
Payne doesn't take Sunday off, neither do we. We're open weekdays 8-8 and weekends 9-6. Just walk into Wellspan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
It's going to be another epic year in high school football, and Sports Radio 1350 is ready for kickoff. Tune in every Friday night this fall for the High School Football Game of the Week,
presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine.
Plus, go to WOIK1350.com for a full breakdown of the teams and the players of the 2015 York Adams League. The High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Catch the action every Friday night on Sports Radio 1350,
online at WOIK1350.com,
or download the WOIK mobile app.
I'm Brandon. I'm an EMT.
And I'm Brandon. When he was in eighth grade.
With Dad's job, we moved around a lot.
So I went to school online at Connections Academy.
Virtual education was more flexible, and I learned to think independently.
I got way organized.
That paid off junior year when I started going to high school here in town, and it's paying off now.
Whoa, you look cool in that uniform.
I know, right? We look cool.
Connections Academy, the tuition-free online public school for grades K through 12. Visit connectionsacademy.com.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK. First in York, first in sports.
We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. It's a 4-2 Bridgeport lead. All runs tonight on homers. Brandon Boggs began the scoring with a two-run shot to left field in the first to put York on top 2-0. And then Bridgeport with a grand slam from the machete, Luis Rodriguez, their catcher. And it's a 4-2 Bluefish lead as we go to the middle innings. Andres Rodriguez, their first baseman, who singled and was on base for the slam in the second, steps in. Logan Williamson goes back to work. The lefty deals an inside fastball to the righty, who chops it up the line at third. Right on top of the bag, fielded on a tough in-between hop by Pounds. Throw to first in time. And Rodriguez is retired, so Brian Pounds, who made a brilliant backhand play on a sharp grounder to get C.J. Rutherford to end the top of the third, makes another play here to begin the top of the fourth. Logan Williamson has now retired his last five batters, all on ground balls to either Pounds or Wilson Valdez, who made a couple of nice plays up the middle as well in that 1-2-3 third. Base is empty, one out, and ball one missing low and away to Wilson Bautista, who singled and scored in the second on the Rodriguez homer. 4-2 Bridgeport, top of the fourth, swing and a miss. Breaking ball diving low and away from Wilson Bautista in the count 1-1. Bautista at third base tonight. The 1-1 offering and shows bunt, overruns it. No contact and called for strike two. 1-2 the count. Williamson, pitch count may be a concern after a long second, but could use another 1-2-3 inning to get back on track in that respect, like he did in the third. This is going to be his 58th pitch of the evening. The lefty kicks and fires, 1-2 on the way, high and away, and the count is 2-2. Wilson Bautista was with the Revolution for the entirety of the 2013 season. Low liner to short on the 2-2, and Valdez snares it. They call it out on the fly. Valdez throws to first.
for the sake of it, but a low liner in Valdez is able to gobble it up, so Bautista lines out. Six in a row retired by Logan Williamson. He has two strikeouts on the night, but the last six batters in a row have either grounded or lined out to third and short. The lefty deals, and the first offering to Matt Wessinger, fouled off out of play, first base side. Wessinger, one of the Williamson strikeout victims, 0 for 1, went down swinging in the second. At short tonight, batting seventh for Bridgeport, the righty stands in. Williamson's 0-1 is lined over the head. No! Climbing the ladder, he makes the grab. I was still technically right. It was over the head of Telvin Nash, but Nash leaping. The cat-like reflexes for the big guy, and he pulls it down. Telvin Nash completes a second consecutive 1-2-3 inning for Logan Williamson, and he's retired seven in a row. And we'll go to the bottom of the fourth, but the Revolution still trailing 4-2. Back in a moment, Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Tennis used to be a very polite game. Today, tennis...
ace.
Raises a racket.
Flying feet.
The style, the play, and the players are intense, athletic, and hard-charging. Sports Shoes welcomes the evolution of tennis and its battling players with a full line of specialty tennis shoes worthy of the new game. These aren't stand-around, look-pretty shoes. These are co-conspirators for the court. Shoes that will endure opponent after opponent, match after match. Shoes that move when and how you move and stop at your command. Shoes that fit and feel good so your feet are ready and able to take that next set. Flying Feet's team includes Asics, New Balance, Wilson, and K-Swiss in widths that fit, and the Flying Feet staff is always on the sidelines ready to help with your selection. Tennis, it's a whole new game. Be prepared to play it well.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes, just off exit 18 of I-83, right behind Domino's in York.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this is sounding just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles. Whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both, it is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com.
Follow York Sports on your Android. Search Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the fourth inning, 4-2, Bridgeport leads it. Pounds, Nash, Paniagua, 5, 6, and 7 due here in the home half of the fourth for the Revs. Paul Braverman sitting in for Daryl Henry here in the middle innings. Thanks for joining us tonight. First of a four-game series that'll wrap around through the holiday on Monday here against the Bluefish as the Revolution in a seven-game homestand trying to bounce back after dropping 2 of 3 to the Camden River Sharks to open the stand. Pound struck out swinging to end the first, 0 for 1. The righty steps in. Lefty Brandon Bixler goes back to work and misses low. And Pound's out in front, 1-0. Pound's maintains his Atlantic League lead in walks, leads the circuit with 59 free passes, and that number makes him third in on-base percentage at .370. And he's tied for fifth in extra base hits this season with 38. 11 of which are home runs, tied with Brandon Boggs for second on the Revolution. Boggs hit his 11th earlier tonight. 2-0 pitch, called for a strike on the inside corner. 2-1 now to Pounds. Brian Pounds is 0-10 on this homestand, still looking for his first base hit since the Revolution returned from a 4-3 road trip. Now he has walked three times, 0-4 yesterday in his struggles, so that's how he's done it this year. His .277 batting average certainly doesn't tell the story. Leading the lead in walks and getting on base 37% of the time. With that plate discipline, he can afford an 0-10 now and again. The 3-1 pitch, Pounds goes for it and pops it up foul. First base side in front of the Revolution dugout. Easy play made by Andres Rodriguez. So Pounds His mini funk continues. He pops out to first. Talvin Nash now, who made the nice leaping play to snare the liner to end the top of the fourth, steps in. Base is empty, one out. It's a 4-2 Bridgeport lead. Robbing Matt Wessinger of a hit a few moments ago. The big righty steps in at first base tonight for York. Flew out to left field in the second. First pitch swinging. Talvin sends it deep to the left field gap. Talvin smash! One-run ball game. A solo shot for Talvin Nash, his fifth with the Revolution. And it's 4-3 Bridgeport in the bottom of the fourth. He wasted little time. He gave it a ride in the second and flied out to the warning track in front of the big wall and left. This time he goes power alley, and power's an understatement. A rocket that wasted little time exiting the grounds at Santander Stadium. Talvin Nash. Base is empty, one out, and the Fish still lead by one. First pitch swinging Salvador Paniagua trying to go back-to-back on back-to-back pitches. A mighty cut, but a swing and the miss, and the count is nothing and one. Paniagua was left at third after a walk in the second. Revs catcher batting seventh tonight steps in, and the righty takes away. One and one the count. Nick Ferdinand waits on deck. The lefty's 1-1, and Paniagua fooled by the off-speed. Swing and a miss, 1-2 to Salvador. So Talvin Nash with his fifth home run of 2015 after joining the Revolution in June. 1-2 pitch, Paniagua grounds it foul, third base side. But that suspended game in Southern Maryland that's being made up a week from today before the regularly scheduled game against the Blue Crabs down in Waldorf. The one that was suspended by weather. It's 1-1 in the fifth inning, or after five innings, and the one Revolution run in that game was a Talvin Nash solo homer. So he hit it. He's getting credit for it, but not until that game becomes final. So he's got five home runs officially, does Nash. Technically six, although one's floating out there in space. Paniagua takes the 1-2 pitch and fouls it back out of play, first base side. A moment ago, he fouled one straight back to the screen, so we're going to do it again for a third time at 1-2 to Salvador. From the stretch, the lefty Bixler will deal now, even with the bases empty and one out. Now he'll go into a full windup, 1-2 offering. Paniagua tried to check his swing, couldn't hold up. Waves at it and goes down on strikes, so two gone. Bases empty, two out, bottom of the fourth, and it's a 4-3 Bridgeport advantage. All of our runs driven in on homers so far tonight. The slam for Luis Rodriguez of Bridgeport. Two-run job for Boggs in the first, and Talvin Nash with a solo shot here in the fourth, and he got every last bit of that one. Nick Ferdinand, a single, but was part of a 6-4-3 double play to end the second, steps in, 1-4-1 in the lefty. Takes sign away, 1-0 the count. Ferdinand did a good job of pulling the ball in the second, turned on an inside fastball, quick hands, and hit it off the bottom of the wall in left field. The 1-0, low and inside, and the righty out ahead, 2-0. Nick Ferdinand getting his first action of this homestand here in game number four. Did not play in the series against Camden. 2-0 pitch, misses high, and the 3-0 upcoming to Nick Ferdinand. Bixler has walked four tonight, but only one has scored. The lefty deals, 3-0 pitch, make it five. He issues his fifth walk here, and we're in the bottom of the fourth to Nick Ferdinand. And the Revolution have a two-out base runner. Andres Perez worked a two-out walk in the first, and Boggs homered. Right behind him, maybe James Simmons could do the same. He hit into a 6-4-3 double play to end the second, 0-for-1. Each team with four hits, and it's a 4-3 Bridgeport lead here in the bottom of the fourth. The home run for Talvin Nash makes him 5-for-10 on this homestand with a double, two RBI, a homer, and three runs scored, and the big guy even stole a base in the series against Camden. Tipped foul, Simmons falls behind 0-1. Four runs, four hits, no errors for Bridgeport. Three runs on four hits and an error for York. James Simmons rounding out the Revolution batting order for the second time tonight in center field and takes it high. 1-1 the count after Jose Constanza's departure to the Tampa Bay Rays. Simmons has pretty much assumed the everyday center field job for York. Ferdinand being held on at first by Andres Rodriguez with two outs after the walk. 1-1 pitch missing high and away, and the count is 2-1. James Simmons 1-for-2 with a double, a run, and two walks yesterday in the loss to Camden. 2-1 pitch misses outside, 3-1 the count. And that suspended game in Southern Maryland, where Telvin Nash is anxiously awaiting his homer to get factored into the stats once it's complete. Simmons is 2-for-2 in that game. And Simmons has been hot as of late. He's driven in 11 runs in the last 2 weeks, 11 RBI in 14 games for Simmons, and he misses high and away with it, does Bixler. And back-to-back two-out walks. So Simmons at first, Ferdinand down to second, and Eric Patterson, who's 1-for-2 tonight with a single and a line-out to short, should be 2-for-2. Wessinger jumped up to rob Patterson of a hit. Patterson will step in for the third time tonight, but not before Ricky Van Asselberg, the Bridgeport manager, is going to come out to the mound. There is warm-up activity in the Bluefish bullpen, and it's been a rough night control-wise for Brandon Bixler. Walked two in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and two here in the fourth. He's got six walks tonight against just three strikeouts, and the change is not going to be made now, even though the manager did visit, as the whole infield was brought together. But I don't know if this guy has another walk in him and be able to stay in the ball game. If he loads the bases here, they're probably going to yank him. Only one of those walks has come in to score, but Bridgeport on the Rodriguez Grand Slam lead 4-3. And even though only one of those six walks have scored thus far, two of them on base now, Ricky Van Asselberg with his team in a second-half division race and very much alive for a playoff spot is not going to dilly-dally here if this lead is in jeopardy of being relinquished, and Patterson's going right after him. First pitch swinging, tips it foul, straight back to the screen, but a big cut by Patterson trying to golf that one. Nothing and one the count. The Revs second baseman 1-for-2 tonight. Warming up is Chad Povich. He's a right-hander in Bridgeport's bullpen. Here's the 0-1, misses low, and the count will move to 1-1 on Patterson. Ferdinand at second, Simmons at first. After allowing the solo shot to Telvin Nash, Bixler struck out Paniagua but then issued a pair of free passes. Patterson hitting in a 1-1 count. From the stretch, the lefty deals, and Bixler misses outside with it. 2-1 is the count. Patterson had the tying run on last night in the bottom of the ninth in the 4-3 loss to Camden, and upset with himself as he flew out to end it. Felt like he missed a pitch, was visibly upset. He's looking to vent some of that frustration by getting good wood on it here and driving in a run or two to possibly give the Revolution the lead or at least tie it. Snap throw to first. He's way off the bag, and Simmons is tagged out. Oh, my goodness. First and second, after a pair of two-out walks, Simmons caught off first. Snap throw from Luis Rodriguez, who even at his advanced age has a great arm behind the plate, and the machete unloads one and picks off Simmons at first with the throw. So the Revolution strand two. Bridgeport continues to lead it 4-3 as we go to the top of the fifth on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
An invasive pest that's already killed millions of ash trees is bearing down on our communities. The emerald ash borer, or EAB, means certain death for every ash tree it infects. The good news is that you can protect your property's ash trees with help from Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. Our EAB prevention methods are effective, environmentally safe, and less costly than removing your dead tree, which is the only alternative to prevention. Learn more at heritagelawnandlandscape.com.
Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats. A savings of 25% over box office prices, plus $10 in free food. So head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Use your gold card every time you shop, and you'll automatically receive your savings and rewards. And you'll get incredible deals on the new Best Yet brand products at Nell's, Sauble's, Wetzel's, Chris's New Oxford, and Stouffer's Downingtown Markets. So get into the game with some great savings at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Always a hit and always a great catch.
There's only one place for local high school sports. Sports Radio 1350.
A base running blunder by James Simmons, picked off first on the snap throw from the catcher Luis Rodriguez, who incidentally will lead off the top of the fifth here. 4-3 Bridgeport leads it. Takes the bat out of Eric Patterson's hands, and after a pair of two-out walks, the Revolution unfortunately strand two. Ball one low to Rodriguez, his grand slam, the only scoring for Bridgeport. Back in the second, 4-3, both scoring plays for the Revolution on home runs. Two-run shot for Boggs in the first, and the Nash solo shot in the fourth. Swing and a miss, and the count is now 1-1 to Luis Rodriguez. Batting eighth behind the plate tonight for the Bluefish, lefty Logan Williamson back to work here in the fifth, and missing low and in. The count is 2-1. Well, they call him the machete, and he's done a lot of chopping tonight. First of the baseball with the grand slam in the second, and then the snap throw down to first to pick off Simmons to end the fourth inning, and a called strike on the 2-1 over the outer corner to Rodriguez. Longtime Bluefish catcher, he goes back all the way to the 2009 season with Bridgeport, so he's been with the Fish a long time. Trademark for Rodriguez is throwing the ball back to the pitcher at a tremendous rate of speed, relatively, and I think that's really how he stays sharp, to help with throwing out base runners, or in the case there, picking a guy off first, as he always stays sharp and always sends it back to the pitcher in a pretty good rate of speed. And now the 3-2 misses low, and Rodriguez works a walk. So the leadoff man on for the second time tonight for Bridgeport here in the top of the fifth inning. Ethan Chapman, center fielder, will round out the Bridgeport order for the second time tonight. Singled, but was part of an inning-ending 5-4-3 double play in the second. First pitch swinging, pops it up. Telvin Nash giving chase over to the Revolution bullpen. First base side, a little bit down the line, falls into the crowd. And nothing and one is the count. Rodriguez at first, nobody out here, top of the fifth, Bridgeport by a run. And Luis Rodriguez, with his elevated age, ...41 years old, January 3rd, 1974. Oldest player in the Atlantic League, Luis Rodriguez. Finding the fountain of youth tonight, a pickoff throw to first and a grand slam, and the count now 0-2 to Chapman, who takes away, and 1-2 now to the left-hander and Bridgeport center fielder. Each team with four base knocks, and it's a 4-3 Bridgeport lead in the top of the fifth. Williamson looking for a ground ball here. After the leadoff walk, the lefty's 1-2. Curveball gets away from him, diving low and away. 2-2 the count. Ethan Chapman joining the Bluefish, after beginning the season with the Philadelphia Phillies at AAA Lehigh Valley in the International League. 2-2 pitch, dribbled foul behind the plate. The count is 2-2. For you Philly fans out there, it seems like Bridgeport has had a pretty good number of guys who are with the Philadelphia organization in AAA. Last year, they had Cody Overbeck, if that name rings a bell, who like Ethan Chapman, the guy at the plate, had gone from Lehigh Valley to Bridgeport. It'll be a 2-2. Williamson fires high and away. 3-2 is the count. So full count offering here, and Williamson trying to avoid walking the first two men. In the top of the fifth inning, the lefty deals, and Chapman pulls it towards second. Patterson on the move, makes the play, throwing on the run in time. That ground ball pulled Patterson into shallow right field, fielding and throwing on the transfer in one smooth motion. The inertia and the momentum taking him away up the foul line from the bag at first. Patterson makes a great play on the move, and Chapman, by no fault of his own, should have been at least an infield single. Robbed by Patterson of a hit, a somewhat simple-looking 4-3 ground out on the score sheet, but hardly routine. And a big first out for Williamson here in the fifth. The leadoff walk, Rodriguez gets down to second, so a runner in scoring position and one out here as the Bluefish try to add to their 4-3 advantage. Brian Sabatella now at the top of the Bluefish order, 0-2, with a flyout and a double play ball. A nice 5-4-3 turn by Brian Pounds in the second. Paniagua needs some reassurance here on the signs with Logan Williamson with Luis Rodriguez at second. Two in the first, one in the fourth, four for the Revolution, four in the second for Bridgeport, all runs tonight on homers. And the way the humidity has seized central Pennsylvania this week, no surprise that the ball is flying well today. Three home runs already. We're only halfway home, as the air is conducive to that ball jumping off the bat today. A humid day here in York County, and ball one misses low to open Sabatella's at bat. Bridgeport leadoff man tonight in left field, the righty, came in batting .274 without a homer and 7 RBI. This is Sabatella's 25th game with Bridgeport, and the 1-0 offering by Williamson misses downstairs, 2-0 the count. A long look in from Williamson, he'll go from the stretch. Paniagua set up target away, and the 2-0. Hits his spot, but it's grounded right back up the middle. Backhanded by Patterson behind the bag at second, but he'll have no play. He'll have to eat it for an infield single. Looked like it would get into center on the roll, but Patterson, another fine play by backhanding it, limiting Sabatella to a one-base hit and perhaps saving a run. Sabatella now 1-for-3. Rodriguez gets down to third, so runners on the corners, one out here. And a bit of a jam for Logan Williamson with the Revs trailing 4-3 in the top of the fifth. Josh Prince has grounded out to Wilson Valdez twice at short. Well, the righty steps in with Williamson in dire need of a double play ball, or at least a grounder on the left side of the infield that'll keep the runner at third, missing inside at the knees of Prince, and the count is 1-0. Josh Prince last with the Erie Seawolves on the other side of this state. They are the AA farm club for the Detroit Tigers in the Eastern League and have been for the last several years. The 1-0 pitch swung on and missed, jammed him low and inside. The count, a ball and a strike to Josh Prince. Luis Rodriguez at third after the leadoff walk. Brian Sabatella at first after the leadoff single up the middle. It'll be a 1-1. Paniagua set up away, and Williamson misses low with it. 2-1 the count to Prince. The leading hitter in the Atlantic League, Wellington Dotel, who entered action today batting .337, waits on deck. So you don't want any piece of him trailing by a run with the bases loaded or two guys on here. So a big spot here for Williamson as he tosses to first. Nash is holding Sabatella to the bag, back standing up, as he does not have a very big lead. He bounces back. Josh Prince in a 2-1 count. Williamson from the stretch with runners on the corners. Glances at Sabatella at first. The 2-1 swing and a miss. Got him chasing away. 2-2 the count. And a strikeout here would be huge for Williamson. It would take the sack fly away for the Atlantic League average leader, Wellington Dotel, who waits on deck. Nash will continue to hold Sabatella on at first. Prince just trying to put it in the air here. From the stretch once more, the 2-2. Paniagua sets up away. It's grounded to third. Runner moving home. Pounds will have him in a rundown. To Paniagua. Back to Pounds. Pounds will run him down for the tag. Two outs. He had Rodriguez off the bag. Not a smart base running play there by the machete. Pounds fields it on a nice hop. And immediately fired a strike home to Paniagua, who played catch with Pounds, and Pounds ran him down for the 5-2-5 putout. And a run is saved. So Sabatella gets down to second, Josh Prince at first with a fielder's choice. Wellington Dotel will still bat with two on, but now two out, and the sack fly off. So Dotel 0-for-2 tonight with a strikeout and a ground out. Leads the Atlantic League in batting at 335 up to the minute. The righty stands in. The Bridgeport right fielder fouls it straight back to the screen, batting third tonight for the Fish, and the count is nothing and one. 4-3 Bridgeport, top of the fifth. Two on and two away as Logan Williamson tries to work out of this jam. Sets at the waist and Paniagua again sets up outside. The lefty's 0-1, misses wildly, low and away. One and one the count, so obviously Williamson, perhaps pitching to this ballpark, does not want to make a mistake on the inner half to the top half of the Bridgeport order and see it get yanked out of here over the big wall and left on the short porch. So he and Paniagua appear to have a game plan to pitch every right-handed hitter away, as Paniagua is basically camped out there now. 1-1 pitch lifted the other way. It's into right. This is going to dunk in for a hit, and a run's going to score. Around third is Sabatella, and it's 5-3 Bridgeport. Wellington Dotel, 1-for-3 tonight. It's his 62nd RBI of 2015. It's an RBI single, as they were afraid he was going to pull it to left. He ends up slapping one the other way to right. And it does just get down in front of Brandon Boggs. So Dotel with the RBI single, and Bridgeport up by two, and it remains two on with two out as Prince gets from first to third. So runners at the corners here for C.J. Rutherford, the Bridgeport DH and cleanup man tonight. Reached on an error in the second, grounded to third in the third. Paniagua sets up inside now to the righty, and Williamson pumps in a called strike. Nothing and one the count. So Dotel takes it the other way to shallow right for the RBI single. First run tonight that has not come on a homer. Five runs on six hits for Bridgeport, three runs on four hits for York. And Tony Pena has commenced warm-up activity in the Revolution bullpen. 0-1 pitch, hammered to left. It's over the head of Ferdinand. One hops the big wall and left, and it'll be 6-3 Bridgeport. A Santander single off the wall and left as Ferdinand, a nice play on the deflection to get it back along the infield to hold it to a single, but C.J. Rutherford with an RBI base hit. And Josh Prince, after he reached on that fielder's choice, scores from third. 6-3, Bridgeport leads it here in the top of the fifth, two runs home. And Wellington Dotel moves from first to third. So still runners on the corners with two out. And Andres Rodriguez is suddenly the seventh batter of the inning for Bridgeport. The Bluefish first baseman, a single and a run in the second, grounded to third in the fourth. Tony Pena warming in the Revs bullpen, and Paniagua and Williamson having a chat here on the mound. And now Mark Mason's coming out as both kind of had their backs turned to the plate. I'm not sure what the tenor of this conversation is, but Paniagua's out there for a long time, and finally Mason decides he has to come out. And is he actually going to take the ball? Yes, he will. 87 pitches for Williamson, so the pitch count was up there for the fifth inning, and Mason decides to go out and pull him on the first visit. So a Maple Donuts pitching change. And Tony Pena will come in and inherit two runners from Logan Williamson, as he's allowed two runs here in the fifth inning, 6-3 Bridgeport. Williamson has allowed seven hits and the grand slam to Luis Rodriguez back in the second tonight. One walk for Williamson, that came this inning, and two strikeouts for him, but none since the second inning, and 52 of his 87 pitches went for strikes tonight. So Maple Donuts pitching change, right-hander Tony Pena comes in. Pena, a wealth of major league experience with the Arizona Diamondbacks, most recently with the Chicago White Sox in the big leagues. Pena, if you're looking to really impress somebody at the next York Revolution party you throw, you can mention that he is the Arizona Diamondbacks' all-time franchise leader in held games and holds. A bit of a newfangled stat, but someone's got to hold it so somebody else can save it. And in the holds department, Pena is the Diamondbacks' all-time leader. Looking at Tony Pena in his 29th game, this will be for the Revolution. A 3.07 ERA to go with a 2-2 record. He has one save in 29 and a third innings. He struck out 27 batters, allowing 10 runs, all of them earned. He's allowed just under a hit per inning, allowing 29 hits in 29 and a third innings. Opponents are batting .257 in 28 games against Tony Pena this season in a Revolution uniform. Andres Rodriguez, as I mentioned, 1-for-2, steps in with runners on the corners and two outs. 6-3 Bridgeport leading York in the top of the fifth tonight at Santander Stadium. Pena will go to work from the stretch. The righty deals low and away, and 1-0 is the count. As York trying to stop the bleeding here, as they've hit the ball well tonight against Brandon Bixler. Three runs should be enough, and a couple of dingers in the first four innings, but Logan Williamson making his first home start in a month, having some uncharacteristic struggles here at Santander Stadium tonight. 1-1 the count to Andres Rodriguez now. Pena, a long look into Paniagua, who sets up outside. Pena has paid little attention to the runners he inherited thus far. And the 1-1 pitch missing high and in to Rodriguez. 2-1 the count. Setting at the waist from the stretch. Paniagua sets up outside again. Swing and a miss. Got him chasing high. Foul tip into Paniagua's glove, and the count is 2-2 to Andres Rodriguez. He's a big one. 6'5", 260. And that 6'5 might be a little conservative. Usually they over-report on the height and under-report on the weight on the roster, but I would have guessed maybe 6'7", but I'll take their word for it at 6'5". 2-2 pitch, low and away, 3-2 the count. So now Pena struggling to throw strikes. Logan Williamson can only be the losing pitcher tonight. Hopefully the Revolution can take him off the hook. Unfortunately, Williamson trying to avoid losing a third straight decision in as many starts. Came in tonight 7-11, but with a solid ERA under 4. 3-2 pitch, swing and a miss, struck him out. So Pena comes in and strands runners on the corners, but after back-to-back RBI singles by Dotel and Rutherford, Bridgeport scores twice in the fifth. Revs coming up down three in the bottom of the fifth when we return on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Maple Donuts knows that there comes a point in every kid's summer when the feeling of unfettered freedom begins to fold up faster than a picnic blanket at the first drop of an unexpected summer storm. Charlie and his Maple Donuts team understand that all too soon, lazy mornings on the sofa, splashing in the pool, and weeknight sleepovers will be replaced by bus stops, backpacks, and morning announcements. But Maple Donuts says there's a bright side to the first day of school, kids. Because when you stumble into the kitchen that first morning, chances are you'll be greeted by Mom, enjoying her cup of Maple Donuts famous coffee and sitting next to a back-to-school tradition, a box of Maple Donuts. And somewhere buried in that box, handpicked by Mom from Maple Donuts 58 varieties, you may find that, yes, summer is over, but another school year may not be so bad after all. So for every kid coming to grips with going back to school, we say thanks, Mom. And thank you, Maple Donuts.
Maple Donuts taste right.
All right, let's try this one. Wherever you are, W-O-Y-K is... That blows. How about... wherever you are, W-O-Y-K is watching. Oh, no, that's creepy. Let's try this. Take Sports Radio 1350 on the go with the new WOYK mobile apps. Available for download today. Bingo. The new Sports Radio 1350. Available anywhere via the WOYK mobile apps. First in York, first in sports.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Well, the Bridgeport starter, Brandon Bixler, has been lifted from this ball game after just four innings. He threw 72 pitches, 32 strikes, and 40 balls. He walked six guys, but the Revolution only made him pay for one. The only one that scored was on the Brandon Boggs two-run homer in the first. And despite six walks and allowing two homers, it's 6-3 Bridgeport as the Revolution come to bat here in the bottom of the fifth inning. And Eric Patterson takes a called strike. Chad Povich, the right-hander on the Maple Donuts pitching change. The new pitcher for Bridgeport, the righty's 0-1. Inside at the knees of Patterson, 1-1 is the count. So allowing four hits, two homers, three runs, and six walks. With just three strikeouts, Bixler won't factor into the decision, leaving after four, but the Revolution probably upset they couldn't make him pay for those free passes, as Patterson had the bat taken out of his hands after a pair of two-out walks on the pickoff that ended the fourth, as James Simmons was caught off first and Rodriguez, the snap throw from behind the plate, ended up getting him. Patterson works ahead 3-1, 1-for-2 tonight. The Revs leadoff man leading off the bottom of the fifth. At second base tonight is Patterson. The lefty stands back in. Chad Povich misses upstairs with the 3-1 pitch. It's the seventh walk tonight total for the Bridgeport pitching staff, and Patterson's down to first. For Chad Povich, has an atrocious ERA of 6.32 in his 24th game this season for Bridgeport, and he's entrusted with a three-run lead here in the fifth. 31 and a third innings, opponents batting .359 off Povich. He's allowed 47 hits in 31 and a third innings, has walked 17 now, striking out 28. Yikes. The righty deals a called strike to the outer corner to Wilson Valdez. Valdez on base twice tonight with a pair of walks. He's walked twice in the seven free passes that have been issued by the Bridgeport pitching tandem of Povich and Bixler before him. Here's the 1-0 pitch, or 0-1, excuse me. Misses low and away, 1-1 the count. Patterson on at first after the leadoff walk held on there by Andres Rodriguez. Sammy the Bull Gervasio warming up in the Bridgeport bullpen in case Povich is true to his poor season numbers here and gets in trouble quickly. But a 1-1 pitch rolled to third. Up, Mr. Fumble Thumbs. Wilson Bautista bobbling that ball. And it was a very makeable play. Should have been an easy out at first at minimum, if not a 5-4-3 double play ball. And he'll get nothing and like it. So the error by Bautista, the first defensive miscue of the night for Bridgeport. Each team with an error now. So Patterson down to second after the walk. Valdez on base three times tonight on the E5. So first and second with nobody out and a pitcher that has struggled all season on the hill in Chad Povich, with warm-up activity really beginning as soon as Povich took the rubber this inning in case he got into trouble. And he is in trouble, but hasn't allowed a hit, a walk and an error. And Andres Perez, the Atlantic League leader in RBI, trying to make him pay for that. So Perez with 14 dingers and 72 batted in, a walk and a run in the first, and struck out looking in the third. He scored on the Boggs homer. After a called strike, the 0-1 pitch missing low and outside, 1-1 the count. 6-3 Bridgeport, bottom of the fifth, but we're far from done with the scoring, methinks, tonight. 6-3, probably not going to be our final this evening. Two on with nobody out for Andres Perez. It'll be a 1-1. Povich deals and missing high with it. 2-1 is the count. Perez has homered each of the last two nights, so looking for a three-game homer streak. Povich from the stretch looks at his runners. Rodriguez sets up outside. Perez goes after it, but pops it up foul behind the plate, not a play. 2-2 the count. Along with the rest of Povich's scary numbers, he's given up four home runs in 31 and a third inning. So that's the one thing. He's kept the ball in the ballpark. It'll be a 2-2. The righty deals. Swing and a pop-up. Perez hit it hard right underneath it. Into shallow center, coming in and making the play is Ethan Chapman. So Perez down and is 0-2 with a walk tonight. Brandon Boggs, the two-run homer, began our scoring in the first. Made it 2-0 Revs. It's 6-3 Bridgeport. Here in the bottom of the fifth, flew out to left to end the third. So Boggs, who homered as a righty off the lefty Bixler, the right-hander Povich, will turn him around to bat lefty here. As Boggs, the potential tying run here, and already a high-scoring game. York down 6-3 here in the bottom of the fifth. And the Revolution really have to strike here. Called for a strike, and the count is nothing and one to Boggs. In a game where there may be more innings scored in than not, you can't squander first and second with nobody out when the two runners reached on a walk and an error. And Rodriguez came out of the crouch for a minute. It looked like they might walk Boggs to get to Pounds, but a little early for that. And a double play set up potentially anyway. 0-1 pitch swung on and missed by Boggs. Bottom dropped out, and the count is nothing and two. Although Brian Pounds on this homestand is 0-11. I'm not sure if Bridgeport realizes that or not, and Boggs has been red hot as of late, as his home run in the second was his second long ball of this homestand. Calls time, steps out, a rogue ball coming down from the Bridgeport bullpen in left field, and the switch hitting lefty will try it again here, an 0-2 pitch upcoming from Chad Povich. The righty deals, swing and a foul ball to the top of the screen behind home plate. Bounces back in play and will do it again at nothing and two. Brian Pounds, I wouldn't quite call it a slump yet, but he could get out of the funk he's been in the last couple days with a bases-loaded knock, or a knock with two guys on potentially here if Boggs can reach. 0-2 offering inside at the knees, and the count 1-2 to the Revolution cleanup man and right fielder tonight. Brandon Boggs is batting over .330. He's 41 for his last 124 over his last 32 games, so he's had a red-hot month. Six doubles, seven homers, 23 RBI, and 22 runs scored. in his last 32 games for Brandon Boggs. Hat tip to Daryl Henry on the game notes here. I don't exactly have that stuff from memory coming into the broadcast booth in the middle innings. 2-2 pitch. He called a strike on that? I didn't see much of a call. Pretty pedestrian ring up there by Warren Nicholson behind home plate. It looked like Pounds had worked a full count, called strike three. So Boggs down, looking for the fourth strikeout of the night for the Bridgeport pitching staff. Povich is first. And the Revs, who had first and second with nobody out, have first and second with two out, and it's up to Brian Pounds. 0 for 2 with a strikeout swinging in the first and a pop out in the fourth. And Pounds takes called strike one. Nothing and one the count. Pounds trying to snap an 0 for 11 slide since the Revolution returned home. The 0-1, and Pounds pops this one straight up in the air. It's tall, but it's to very shallow center, so shallow that Josh Prince, the second baseman, will backpedal and make the play himself. So a leadoff walk and an error put Patterson and Valdez on to lead the inning, and the Revolution come up dry. It's 6-3 Bridgeport as we go to the top of the sixth. Daryl Henry returns in a moment. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our Atra certified technicians. Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they helped me with financing. Still with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
Hi, I'm Jeremy, and I just got into veterinary school.
And I'm Jeremy when he was in the fifth grade.
That's when my parents enrolled me in Connections Academy.
And when we got my puppy Champ, and I started dreaming of being a vet.
They said at Connections Academy I'd have an even brighter future. I had great teachers and classes that really prepared me for college success.
I guess my hard work paid off for you.
Sure did. For all of us. Right, Champ?
Connections Academy, the tuition-free online public school for grades K through 12. Visit ConnectionsAcademy.com.
On air, online, and on your smartphone. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Hi, this is Stephen Penny, and you're listening to York Revolution Baseball in the home of the Revs. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the sixth, 6-3, Bridgeport in front. Tony Pena will stay on for the Revs. Wilson Batista leading off and shows a bunt, takes a strike. My thanks to Paul for the last couple of innings. And not the prettiest game so far tonight. All the walks, some missed opportunities for the Revs. Not a great base running display tonight. Next one is outside. It's a 1-1 count. So trailing at 6-3 and looking to find their way back at some point. Batista 1-for-2. There's the 1-1 pitch. He bunts toward third, but foul. Bunted it hard all the way just about parallel with the bag at third base. And Pena staying on after striking out Andres Rodriguez to end the fifth inning. He faced one batter. Will now look to work the sixth. Six runs, seven hits, one error for Bridgeport, 3-4-1 for York. Batista deep crouch from the left-hand box. The 1-2, and it misses up high. 6, 7, and 8 in the Bluefish order due to bat. And Pena readies with it. The 2-2. Check swing, he went. On a changeup down out of the zone, Batista couldn't hold, and Pena has struck out his first two batters face. One down here in the top of the sixth. On our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard, Lancaster has struck first. They lead Camden 2-0 in the bottom of the fifth. Big night for the Rebs tonight, and trying to come back. Here's Matt Wessinger, who pops the first pitch up. Way up in the infield, pounds down from third in foul territory. He's got it. About halfway down the line. Couple of steps over the line. And a quick two outs. I'm going to bring up Luis Rodriguez, who connected on a second inning grand slam. Also walked in the fifth. That gave Bridgeport the lead. They've held it at varying margins since. It's Pena's pitch. And a fastball missing up and away. Elsewhere, Somerset with two first inning runs. They're up 2-0 at Sugar Land in the first. Long Island leads Southern Maryland 2-1 in the seventh. And the 1-0 pitch. And there's a slider for a strike. Good one from Pena. One swung on, line to center field. Simmons reading it. It starts to hook, and he has to hustle over into left center and lunge down. Makes the play. Quick 1-2-3, sixth inning for Tony Pena. We go to the bottom of the sixth tonight. Still the Bluefish 6, the Rebs 3.
Providing quality services efficiently and in a timely manner to its clients is the mission of the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins. GSLSC is equipped to handle any real estate transactions, leases, residential and commercial real estate settlements, zoning issues, and all matters involving municipalities. They are also experienced in the formation and operation of family real estate ventures that are tax-sensitive to the needs of the investors. Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins is an approved title insurance agency and can provide you with title insurance and legal representation at one low cost when buying a home or investment property. Don't risk any real estate settlement without an experienced real estate attorney from the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins at your side. Phone 717-757-7602. They've been handling residential and commercial real estate matters in South Central Pennsylvania for more than 50 years. With mortgage interest rates at an all-time low, now is the time to buy or refinance. Phone 717-757-7602 today or visit their website, gslsc.com.
Savory's Funnel Cakes have brought their delicious funnel cakes from the York Fair to Santander Stadium. Be sure to visit their stand on the third base concourse near the Hop Corner, as they offer both regular and pumpkin funnel cakes. Also, be sure to check out Savory's Funnel Cake Eating Challenge played between innings during York Evolution home games. They also offer event catering. Give Savory's a call at 717-271-3485. That's 717-271-3485. Savory's Funnel Cakes, York's delicious delicacy for all to enjoy.
The radio home of the Revs. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bridgeport. We head to the bottom of the sixth. Right-hander Sam Yervasio is the new pitcher. He of the sideways cap tilted upward off the side of his head. It's his fashion statement. Now he takes over on a Maple Donuts call to the bullpen. I enjoyed Talvin Nash's couple of innings in the fourth and fifth. He hit a home run in the fourth, his fifth of the year, actually his sixth when you factor in the suspended game. And then at first base, when Ethan Chapman ran into him, Nash didn't go anywhere, and Chapman bounced right off of him like he ran into a wall. I'm sure he did that on the high school football field to some offensive players. The former D end who was headed to the U to play football, if not for being drafted high by Houston. And Yervasio's first pitch, a slider way in that bounces away to the backstop. And Bridgeport, after their starter went four, they're on their second reliever. Here's a slider over for a strike. Rebs have stranded five tonight, but also base running mistakes, additional runners erased. The slider down and away that squirts by, 2-1. Last inning, two on, nobody out. But Povich got the 3-4-5 hitters. 2-1. Swung on, lined hard, out of the reach of Wessinger at short. It's into left center. Nash with a bullet for a base hit. And he's 2-for-3. That ball ripped. That is his third straight two-hit game. And here's Paniagua. Really frustrating thing. The Revs have drawn 7 walks tonight, 6 by the starter, and they have not come close to taking advantage. Only one of those has scored. Pitch to Pani is lined, and fair down the left field line. Nash heading to third base, Paniagua to second, and he'll cruise in with a double. Revs are in business here in the sixth. It's second and third with nobody out. Another extra base hit for Paniagua, who's been terrific here lately. And second and third for Nick Ferdinand. Down 6-3 and looking to make a run back at it here. Ferdinand a single and a walk tonight, and now time asked for by the catcher. He singled off the base of the arch nemesis in the second. First pitch is down low for ball one. That wind blowing out to left at a pretty good clip, by the way. Just looking up at the flag and noticing that again. 1-0, and a slider bites across for a strike. Yervasio out of their bullpen, 5-4 with a 3.56 ERA this year. He should help their walk problems, only 10 in 48 innings. Here's a swing and a ground ball to third. Batista's got it. He's throwing home. The slide. Nash is in! 6-4. He slides around it. And still nobody out. And here comes Ricky Van Asselberg to argue the call from Warren Nicholson at the plate. Yervasio threw his arms up in disbelief. And Nash slid to the front of the plate. Nicholson said he got the foot in. Batista threw home, the throw beat him. But Nash didn't break stride, he slid hard, and you know, it's fair to wonder when you see that freight train coming toward the plate, how badly do you want to hang in there and apply the tag? Rodriguez may have pulled up a little short seeing him charging home. And it's a 6-4 game, first and second, still no outs. On the replay, looks like they got it right. Here's James Simmons. First pitch is down and away. So now the Revs get a miscue and an extra out from Bridgeport as they look to take advantage. Simmons will meet with Polo halfway to third and talk about the plan here, wondering if a bunt might be on. Looked like Rodriguez was kind of backing up when he took that throw home, and Nash clearly got in on the replay. Pitch to Simmons is bunted, and it's foul over on the third base side. the stretch. Corners are in. And he squares. Pitch is a slider away. Did he pull it back in time? He did. No appeal yet. Now they ask for one. And down at first base, John Harrington says no. And now Gervasio flailing his arms around, upset about that. I think his first baseman, Rodriguez, is trying to tell him to don't worry about it, just focus on the hitter. Simmons will square again. Corners are in, the 2-1, he bunts foul. Over along the third base side again. The slider that started at him, and it looked like he buckled slightly and bunted in self-defense almost. Now 2-2. And the corners will sit back with two strikes. Pitch, swing and a miss. Got him on a slider for the first out of the inning. That one away and back to the top of the order, and Eric Patterson. Patterson tonight, 1-for-2, single, walk. Hard hit out that was caught at short. He's got two on with one out here. And the first pitch, slider. Gervasio bends it in for a strike. He's walked only 10 this season. He's now struck out 56 out of their bullpen. Now ready. The 0-1 swung on, bounced foul. That smacked the top of the padding by the front row. Just short of the Revs dugout. No balls, two strikes. And the pitch. Fastball up and away. Patterson lays off. Number 1-2 swung on and dribbled foul again. Over against the Revs dugout. Gervasio from Sabana de la Mar, Dominican Republic. 5'11 righty. Made it as high as fourth on the Houston Astros prospect list back in 2010. He was in the majors 29 games the year before that, six games in 2010. 2009, a 2.14 ERA in the majors. 1-2, way in, and it got by Rodriguez. Got a little piece of it, but all the way to the backstop. And both will move up. It's a wild pitch. They're down two. Two runners move along, potentially big. And now things change a little bit as far as the opportunity for Patterson. Two balls and two strikes. Bridgeport up two, the infield with two runners in scoring position stays back. Now the stretch, the 2-2, swung on, line to right field, right at Dotel. Paniagua will tag, here he comes, throw is offline, he scores, it's deflected away, Ferdinand will take third, a 6-5 game. And Eric Patterson with the sack fly on a line drive to right. Revs with two in the inning and back within a run. Paniagua, obviously not the team's fastest, but Dotel's throw was a few steps off to the right of the plate, and Rodriguez couldn't knock it down, so once it slightly got by, Ferdinand moved up two, and Dotel will be given an error on that throw. RBI number 47 of the year for Patterson, and Ferdinand at third for Valdez. And the first pitch is down and away. Rodriguez getting the glove down around it on the backhand. Now the 1-0, and that sails wide, a slider. Patterson's 171st RBI all-time with York. He's two away from tying Chris Noack for fourth in Revs history. On a stretch, the 2-0, and a slider over for a strike. Not for that wild pitch, that would not have been a run. 2-1, slider low and away. Valdez tonight, 0-for-1. He has gotten on twice on walks. So 3-1, swung on, chopped toward third and foul. Now a full count. Another big play in the inning was the play where Batista threw home and Nash slid in safely. That could have been an out for Bridgeport. Rams have taken advantage and within one, now trying to tie it. Gervasio set and the 3-2 slider, strike three called. Valdez was starting toward first. He's not happy one bit. He's got the finger point going at Nicholson. He says no, but he's rung up, and he's disgusted as he slams his helmet down. Revs leave the tying run at third base. They do score twice on two hits, one error, and one left. We go to the seventh. It's 6-5 Bridgeport.
Want to learn to skate? Want to suit up and learn how to play some hockey? Come to the coolest place in town, York Ice Arena. Learn to skate programs are now available for all ages. For every skating ability, kids of all ages will learn how to feel comfortable on ice, how to stand, and perhaps most importantly, how to fall properly. Class levels range from beginner to freestyle, where you'll learn basic jumps, spins, and footwork. Classes are taught by York Ice Arena skating instructors from White Rose Figure Skating Club. No skates? No problem. Skate rental is included in your registration. Or get on the ice for our York Ice Arena hockey programs. York Ice Arena coaches will focus on teaching proper techniques needed for anyone interested in playing hockey. Rental equipment is available for beginning players, both boys and girls. So get on the ice. Learn to skate. Learn to play. Sign up now. Group skating lessons and beginners hockey programs are forming now. Plus, York City residents get a 50% discount. Register today. Go to yorkskate.com and click on program info. York Ice Arena, the coolest place in town.
Hey, sports fans, great news. Now you can listen to Sports Radio 1350 anywhere with the new WOYK mobile apps. Stranded in Siberia? No problem. Kidnapped by wolves? It's not as bad as you may think. Wherever you are, WOYK is with you on a brand new mobile apps. York's only local sports station just went mobile and global. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports. All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the seventh, 6-5. Bridgeport leads it. Revs back within a run. Tony Pena stays on. First pitch to Ethan Chapman is in for a strike. Pena an inning and a third thus far. And we'll at least begin the seventh inning also. Here's the 0-1. And Chapman tries to bunt his way on. Pena misses it. He'll head to first. Nash the flip, and he can't get there on the speedy Chapman, who bunts for a hit right between the two. And they had to run their respective routes, one to the ball, one to the bag, but Chapman was the quicker. And Pena went for it, couldn't reach it initially. Nash came off, was able to play it. But Pena then had to run toward first, find it while looking back for the flip. And his lunge for the bag, not in time. So the leadoff man is on. It's the first base runner against Pena, who had set down his first four. Yeah, here's Sabatella, who tries to bunt him over, and he fouls it. Back behind the plate. My pen went walking off again. Again. I know where it went, Matt. I know who took it, but it's gone. And I know it wasn't you. Here's the 0-1, and Pena misses high. Paul came in to grab his meal voucher, and he used my pen, and now it's gone. That's what happened. I see it. It's out there in the press box. That's my pen. Pitch is bunted toward the first base side again. Nash bare hands. He flips, and this time got him. Sacrifice is good. 3-4 on the out with Patterson over to cover. Close play. Another good bunt from the Bluefish. And this one goes down as the sacrifice. As Sabatella moves Chapman up to second with one out. Good job by Patterson to hustle over and cover. A runner at second, one away. Josh Prince, the hitter. 6-5 Bridgeport, they're trying to add to it. First pitch to Prince is swung on and missed. And that go-to slider from Tony Pena. Ball loose from Bridgeport's bullpen, so we wait momentarily. Prince 0-3. Did score a run back in the fifth. The 0-1, and it's down and away. Great backhand pick by Paniagua to keep Chapman at second base. Revs have some further bullpen activity now also. Longest that Pena's gone has been two innings, twice. He deals, and it's inside, 2-1. Revs fans wanted that pitch. Couple of bunts have the Bluefish threatening. Here's the 2-1. And a swing and a foul tip back behind the plate. I have switched to a pen that I didn't steal, but just made its way into my bag from a hotel room. Magically bounced right into my bag. The 2-2, swung on, grounded softly to first. Nash will glove it, and he'll take it to the bag himself. Chapman moves to third base. He Williams there with two away. So they'll deal with Wellington Dotel, trying to keep this a one-run game. The league leader in hitting, making his way to the plate. Tonight, 1-for-3, an RBI on a blue pit, of all things, that he lobbed into shallow right with two outs in the fifth. It was an incredibly frustrating run for Williamson, who was an out away from finishing the inning. First pitch is swung on, driven to straightaway center. Simmons going back on it, and he's got room. Makes the play. Pena claps into his glove as he marches off. He works out of it, and it's still a one-run game as we head to the stretch. Simmons backing up in deep center. He had it. No runs, one hit, and one left. Stretch time here at the bank. Revs trail 6-5.
Nobody can turn your backyard into a backyard paradise better than Paradise Landscaping and Hardscaping. The outdoor pros at Paradise offer full outdoor maintenance, landscaping, hardscape design, and installation. And when it comes to fall planting, mulching, and cleaning up fallen leaves, you're in luck, Revs fans. Call before September 1st to schedule your fall cleanup and clean up with 10% off. Estimates are free. Fully insured. Call 577-6234 or check them out on Facebook. Paradise Landscaping and Hardscaping in your
Wellspan has helped many professional, student, and recreational athletes stay at the top of their game. And they can do the same for you. Our winning team offers everything from concussion management and sports nutrition to physical therapy and more. For more information, call 877-482-5420 or visit wellspan.org/sportsmedicine.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Use your gold card every time you shop and you'll automatically receive your savings and rewards. And you'll get incredible deals on the new Best Yet brand products at Nell's, Sauble's, Wetzel's, Chris's New Oxford, and Stouffer's Downingtown Markets. So get into the game with some great savings at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Always a hit and always a great catch.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Six-five Bridgeport. We go to the bottom of the seventh as they make a pitching change, calling on right-hander Eric Draxton. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Dre leads off. First pitch is chopped to short. Couple hops to Wessinger. He gloves, fires across. One pitch, one out. Draxton is 3-1 at 2.49 ERA, 49 games. He's done a nice job for them. Does a very nice job there. One out on one pitch. Here's Brandon Boggs. First offering is over for a strike. Boggs 1-for-3 tonight. Two-run homer in the first. His 11th. The 0-1. And it's up and in, a slider. The 1-1 and a foul tip back to the netting. Brian Pounds taking his hacks on deck. One, two, swung on, line foul the other way. Jeez, into the stands in left. Somebody just missed it. There was another person who had her back to the play. Flew right past her, too. Boggs, the 11 home runs, the most in a season by a switch hitter in Revs history. pitch to him. Swinging a foul tip straight back. Previous record was 9 by Brian Bergamy early in 2013. Boggs has hit most of them from the left side of the plate, but hit one off the lefty tonight. And a slider here froze him. He's rung up. He knew it. And Draxton sets down his first two here in the bottom of the seventh. And here's Pounds. Home run for Boggs was his third off left-handers this season. Pounds tonight, hitless in 3 at-bats. First pitch, a slider over for a strike. By the way, tomorrow morning, be on at 9 until 10 for Central PA game day. So tune in for all of the results from week 1 of high school football. A slider in the dirt, 1 ball, 1 strike. One-one, fastball just outside. Also, tomorrow at 11:30 a.m., Stanford at Northwestern, College Football Saturday. Tonight after the game, we'll join Washington at Boise State in progress. Here's a swing and a liner to right field. Dotel hustles in. He dives and makes the grab. And he left some divots behind in right field. Diving in, laying out, makes the catch, falling forward, and robs Pounds. It's a 1-2-3 seventh inning. We go to the eighth here tonight. Still a 6-5 Bridgeport lead.
Providing quality services efficiently and in a timely manner to its clients is the mission of the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus, and Calkins. GSLSC is equipped to handle any real estate transactions, leases, residential and commercial real estate settlements, zoning issues, and all matters involving municipalities. They are also experienced in the formation and operation of family real estate ventures that are tax sensitive to the needs of the investors. Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus, and Calkins is an approved title insurance agency and can provide you with title insurance and legal representation at one low cost when buying a home or investment property. Don't risk any real estate settlement without an experienced real estate attorney from the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus, and Calkins at your side. Phone 717-757-7602. They've been handling residential and commercial real estate matters in South Central Pennsylvania for more than 50 years. With mortgage interest rates at an all-time low, now is the time to buy or refinance. Phone 717-757-7602 today or visit their website, gslsc.com.
This is the Dan Patrick Show.
He's a great, great man. Was Muhammad Ali a thug? He was colorful, controversial. But this is a guy who did something before anybody else did it, and we were okay with it. A lot of us were okay because of how Ali looked. Handsome, well-spoken, and poetry. There was charisma to it. Richard Sherman just came out of a game and started yelling right in our face.
Dan Patrick on Sports Radio 1350 WOIK. The Revolution plays here. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Head of the eighth, Edward Paredes will take over. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Revs still down a run, 6-5. Middle third of the order for Bridgeport coming up. Beginning with C.J. Rutherford. Take a look at our WellSpan Sports Medicine injury report tonight. Ian Durham and Brad Bergeson out with the elbow injuries. Anthony LaRue, the broken leg. That's your WellSpan Sports Medicine injury report. First pitch of the inning from Paredes is over for a strike. Rutherford, a former Arizona State Sun Devil, made it to AAA with the White Sox. It's the 0-1, and he swings and fouls it back. with Long Island for 18 games last season. Also in the American Association. Tonight, 1-for-3 with an RBI single. The 0-2. Swing and a miss. Reaching at a change away. Popped out of Paniagua's glove. He'll throw it down to first base. And I think he threw it down to Nash so that he could step on first. But Rutherford was already walking back to their dugout, so he was out anyway. One down. Here is Andres Rodriguez. Paredes, 4-1, a 3.10 ERA in 47 games. That's his 60th strikeout in 49 and two-thirds this season. First pitch is inside. Rodriguez tonight, 1-for-3, singled and scored in the four-run second inning when they took the lead. They've yet to relinquish that. The 1-0 swung on and foul tipped off Paniagua's gear. And on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard, still 2-0 Lancaster. Bottom of the seventh inning, hosting Camden. There's the 1-1 fastball strike. Inside corner, Rodriguez had something to say as he stomps around behind home plate. On our York Mitsubishi High School scoreboard, the game on WOYK1350.com right now, Central a 24-14 lead at West York in the fourth. It's the 1-2, and it misses high and away. That's our high school game of the week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. There's a couple of games, West and South, that are in weather delays. Southwestern up 24-0 against Gettysburg at halftime. That's in a delay. And Kennerdale trailing Waynesboro 20-9 at the half, also in a weather delay. Now the stretch and the 2-2. And it's chopped to third. Pounds will back up to play it neatly. Fires across and got him. Very nicely done. It was the initial read off the bat. And he drops step back, played it to his left on the second hop with some top spin on it. Didn't have much time to react to the hop either, but speared it cleanly and made the throw. Two down. Here's Wilson Batista. 1-for-3 tonight. Single and a run back in the second. First pitch, it is off the plate away. Revs tomorrow night hosting youth football night here at the stadium. Postgame fireworks as well. The 1-0 and a foul tip back to the net. Youth football and spirit night, I should say. Fans encouraged to wear their favorite football jersey to the game tomorrow night. Tickets on sale, YorkRevolution.com, 717-801-HITS, and at the Apple Chevrolet ticket office. Parade is set. Here's the 1-1. That missed high and away. Fireworks presented by Signs by Tomorrow. Batista now 11-for-21 against York with the Bluefish. The 2-1 breaking ball, swing and a miss. Good one from Eddie. Into his stretch, the 2-2 swung on, driven to right field, backing up is Boggs, and he's got it. Line drive right to him, backing up a couple of steps, and Eddie with a 1-2-3 top of the eighth. Bottom half of the eighth inning here, Revs trail the Bluefish 6-5.
Payne doesn't take Sunday off, neither do we. We're open weekdays 8-8 and weekends 9-6. Just walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
It's going to be another epic year in high school football, and Sports Radio 1350 is ready for kickoff. Tune in every Friday night this fall for the High School Football Game of the Week, presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine. Plus, go to WOIK1350.com for a full breakdown of the teams and the players of the 2015 York Adams League. The High School Football Game of the Week, presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine. Catch the action every Friday night on Sports Radio 1350, online at WOIK1350.com, or download the WOIK mobile app.
We're everywhere. Listen on the go with the WOYK mobile apps. Download today at WOYK1350.com.
Summer is about taking time for what really matters. Spending time with the family, enjoying nature's beauty, having a healthy lawn you can be proud of, plus the time to enjoy it. With Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care, you get world-class environmentally responsible lawn care from a hometown team. The result is a vibrant, beautiful lawn that turns heads and boosts curb appeal. Visit us at heritagelawnandlandscape.com.
Your home for Revolution Baseball, Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the eighth, 6-5. Bridgeport still leads. Right-hander Stephen Ames is their new pitcher. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Talvin Nash will be the first to face him. A good night for Nash tonight. 2-for-3, homered in the fourth. Couple of runs scored. It's his third straight two-hit game, and that wind is blowing to left if he can get a hold of one. Not that he needs it. First pitch slider is a called strike. Not that he needs the wind. Ames, a rare reliever these days from a windup, and he misses down and away. It's a very rushed first couple of steps into his windup. Very quick one. And the wind, the 1-1, swing and a miss, a high fastball. Ames 1-2, a 3.52 ERA, couple saves in 27 outings. Wines, deals, swing and a miss. It bounces out of Rodriguez's glove. Nash stopped. He thought he fouled it. And Rodriguez throws to first to complete the out. Nash is trying to show Warren Nicholson where on the bat he tipped it. He's claiming that he foul tipped it. The plate ump said he didn't make any contact. And now Mace coming out to try to help save his player here and maybe get them to ask for help, but I don't know how you could ask anybody else. And Nash not giving it up. He's pleading his case as Mays steps in between him. Him and Nicholson. That's big. That's a guy who's swinging the bat well that you want up there in a one-run game. And it looks like his at-bat is finished. I don't see how they could ask for help on it, and they won't. But Nash obviously thought they screwed it up. One down, here's Paniagua. Sal 1-for-2 tonight, doubled and scored in the sixth, also a walk. First pitch is swung on and missed, a slider. No one, man, that's way high. Ames some big league time to his name. He was in the majors with the Marlins for four games in 2013. Former Gonzaga Bulldog. He deals, swing and a miss, a slider. Drafted by the Dodgers in 09 out of Gonzaga. He's from Vancouver, Washington. 27-year-old righty, the pitch, and it's grounded foul down at the end of Bridgeport's dugout. 1-2 it remains. He was traded from the Dodgers to the Marlins as part of the deal that sent Ricky Nolasco to L.A., and then Ames would make his big league debut with the Marlins later that year. He's a swing and a foul tip. That one, Paniagua clearly got a piece of. And it got a piece of Rodriguez, who needed a moment. Joe Pani got just enough of it to keep his at-bat going. Two again, and a swing and a foul back over the roof. The Revs, a one-run loss last night. They're down a run tonight. Last night, just their fourth one-run loss at home in 16 one-run home games all year. Pitch is swung on, fouled off, right field side. Bridgeport's closer is Patrick Mincy, so Ames is trying to serve as the bridge to him. Another 1-2, swing and a miss. A slider in the dirt, Rodriguez blocks. He'll take his time stepping out to grab it and make the throw. And a pair of strikeouts here in the eighth. Good two-strike battle from Paniagua, but Ames wins the battle. Two down and Nick Ferdinand to the plate. Ferdinand tonight, 1-for-2, a single, a walk, and an RBI fielder's choice. And Ames from his windup, first pitch, slider is drilled, deep left field, game tied! Nick Ferdinand ties it up! First pitch swinging, he hammers it out of here. And it's a 6-6 game here in the bottom of the eighth. No doubt he crushed it, his ninth of the year. And his teammates fired up for him as they wait for him in the dugout, back in the lineup tonight, and what a night he's had. And the Revs' third long ball of the game. A slider that hung middle, little bit down, but he was all over it. And here's James Simmons, who looks at one low. Ferdinand had been in a scuffle. Here's the 1-0. And a slider just missed. It's his ninth home run of the year, his first since July 15th. He was on that tear when he first got here, and he looks like that hitter again tonight. There's a pitch outside, 3-0. The Revs were down 6-3 in the fifth. They scored two in the sixth, and now one here in the eighth to tie it. And Ames missing with three straight after serving up the bomb. Here's the 3-0 to Simmons and taking a strike. He had struck out the first two of the inning. But then tried a slider to get one over on Ferdinand. He was sitting on it. Pitch is up high and Simmons walks. So the inning continues. Eric Patterson at the top of the order coming up. That homer for Ferdinand, the Revs second to clear the big wall tonight. They've played some wall ball this evening. He hit one off of it earlier. And Bridgeport's got one that's gone over. Pitch to Patterson is in for a strike, knee high. Patterson one for two, has a sack fly. Also reached on a walk. Now tied at six in the bottom of the eighth. On Ferdinand's shot. The 0-1, that's in the dirt as Rodriguez blocks it. Revs second in the league now with 90 home runs on the season, three tonight. Three righties. Pitch here is fouled off. Back and out of play, 1-2. Lancaster entered the night with 100 home runs, leading the league. The Revs with 90 now. Ames ready, the 1-2, swung on, fouled off to the left. Ferdinand's now one away from giving the Revs a fourth player in double figures in homers. Patterson's also one away from doing that. Aim set and deals and a swing and a ground ball toward the middle. Diving stop, Wessinger. He throws it away and it goes out of play in the Revs dugout. It'll be second and third, and the inning's not done yet. Infield hit for Patterson, a throwing error on the shortstop, their third error of the night. And it's second and third with Wilson Valdez coming up, trying to give York the lead. A hit for Patterson. Wessinger made a great play, sprawled out to reach it. But then as he popped to his feet, his throw sailed high, went into the dugout right at the far end. Now it's second and third. For Valdez. 0 for 2 tonight. Couple of walks. Here's the stretch. First pitch is swung on, driven in center. Carrying on Chapman, who backs up and puts it away. He was shallow and he hesitated. And Valdez hit it deep. He got a late break, but backing up was able to flag it down. So if the Revs are to win tonight, they'll have to do it in walk-off fashion for the 10th time this season. They do tie it on Ferdinand's long ball. One run, two hits, one error, and two left. We go to the ninth. It's 6-6.
Melissa. I teach 10th grade English.
And I'm Melissa when she was in 10th grade at Connections Academy.
That was the year my teachers changed the way I looked at literature.
Our class discussions opened my eyes.
At Connections Academy, the great courses and personal attention really made a difference.
I'm more confident.
My Connections Academy teachers inspired me so much, I became one myself.
I better read faster.
Connections Academy, the tuition-free online public school for grades K through 12. Visit connectionsacademy.com.
When she looks up and says, "Dad, I'm playing field hockey," try not to show fear. She's quite capable of joining that fury of females churning downfield, sticks in hand, ready to conquer and crush the opposition. In fact, in her mind, she's been ready to play. But you won't be ready until you take her to Flying Feet Sports Shoes.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet is the one place that makes sense of all the sports your kids are into, especially field hockey footwear. No, it's not just sneakers, Dad. She'll need shin guards and socks, and don't forget hockey balls, stick bags, grip tape, and hockey sticks from Dita and Gray's Cranberry. Flying Feet covers every player, every size, every ability, even goalie sticks. Dad, you're about to get an education on the art of fierce female competitive instinct, but Flying Feet can help you navigate that treacherous turf. They've been outfitting field hockey players and entire teams since your wife played back in 83.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes, 1511 Mount Rose Avenue, York, just off exit 11 of I-83.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
If you like power hitting, tonight has been a nice night to watch. Revs with three long balls, the third of which from Nick Ferdinand moments ago has tied it up 6-6 as we go to the ninth. And Mike DeMarc takes over. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. He'll face Matt Wessinger leading things off. 7-8-9 in the order for Bridgeport. And DeMarc ready to go as he stretches, fires, and a fastball in for a strike. Saw him work a scoreless inning in the game last night. Revs were down a run in the ninth. Tonight they are tied thanks to that most recent blast. Pitch is over for a strike, a slider for strike two. DeMarc jumps ahead. And he's set. 0-2 pitch. Missed down low. Another 1-2. And that misses in the dirt. Paniagua down on top of it. The Wessinger, Rodriguez, and Chapman here in the ninth. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. A foul tip squeezed. DeMarc strikes out Wessinger. A slider up. Got him to go after it. One away here in the top of the ninth. DeMarc, no record in 19 games. One save. 18 and a third innings, three runs, two earned. The second one a surprise that came up yesterday. A scoring decision at Somerset over the weekend that was never relayed. Here's a swing and a pop-up from Luis Rodriguez on the first pitch. Valdez out, Simmons in. Simmons takes it in shallow center. A pop-up. And Rodriguez is out on one pitch for out number two. Bluefish have lefty Jimmy Patterson up in their bullpen. If the game's tied, they have their closer, Patrick Mincy, up. If they should, heaven forbid, go in front. Here's Ethan Chapman. Corners are in, and DeMarc fires a strike. Chapman 2-for-3 on the night. It's the 0-1. And that misses down low. 1-1 pitch. Slider, that breaks low as well. And 2-1 to the lefty. Oh, didn't get the outside corner. 3-1. Now Chapman gets on. He does have good speed. 3-1. Swings and misses. On a high fastball, he came out of his shoes trying to hit it. Count goes full as DeMarc tries to get his team back to the plate. The payoff pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. On a high fastball, Mike DeMarc, a 1-2-3, top of the ninth. The Revs with Perez, Boggs, and Pounds due up. Bottom of the ninth inning, trying to win it. We're tied at six.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this has sounded just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles. Whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both, it is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our ATRA-certified technicians.
Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they help me with financing. Still, with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA-approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
Join me, Steve Zabin, mornings at 6 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the ninth, left-hander Jimmy Patterson will come on for Bridgeport. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. And it'll be Perez, Boggs, and Pounds. Tied at six. And looking for walk-off win number 10. Patterson ready to go, facing Dre. And the lefty's first pitch is outside. Perez 0 for 3 tonight, walked and scored in the first. And the wind and the 1-0. Swung on, line to left center field and in for a hit. Leadoff single, they were deep. Chapman cuts it off, but the winning run is on. Leadoff base hit. And Brandon Boggs up next. Revs with 9 walk-offs. The previous record was 8 back in 2009. 19-11 in games decided in a team's final at bat. Here's Boggs, who homered to open the scoring in the first. First pitch is down and away. He's 1-for-4 on the night with that home run. Patterson in 7 games, 1 win, 1 loss. 10 innings, 11 hits, 3 runs, only 1 earned. He's struck out 11. Stretch, the 1-0, and a fastball for a strike, 89 to the outer half. Patterson had made it to AAA in the Rays system. Time asked for by Boggs. Patterson, a reliever for the most part throughout his career. 3 times promoted to AAA, including earlier this season. Stretch and the 1-1. And that's over for a strike, a changeup. Revs tonight also going for their 599th win all time. Two away from 600. Now set with it. 1-2. Swung on and loop foul back. Out of play. Perez held it first, not much of a lead against a lefty. Here's the pitch. Swung on, hit in the air, shallow left center. Chapman was deep, dives and makes a great grab for the first out. He was deep and came jetting in. Covered a ton of ground into shallow left center, dove for it, and at full extension, got his glove under it as it was falling to the turf. One away as Boggs made a bid for a blue pit that could have really had them set up pretty. Here's Brian Pounds, who's 0 for 4. Perez at first with one out. We're tied at 6 here in the bottom of the ninth. First pitch, a fastball strike over the outer half. Revs were down 6-3 in the fifth. They scored 2 in the sixth. Tied it on Ferdinand's home run in the eighth. The 0-1. And it's down and away, a changeup. The game does go extras. Stephen Penny is getting loose. Patterson set, and a move over to first base. Perez back standing. Patterson's another Arizona State guy. C.J. Rutherford, a product of the Sun Devils as well. Patterson, a 26-year-old lefty, released by the Rays on August 10th. 1-1. Swung on, line to right field, it's in for a hit. Over toward the line, Perez is going to sprint to third. Dotel's throw gets away, and it will be backed up by Patterson, but Pounds takes second. Takes away the double play, he moves up an extra base. It's second and third, the winning run 90 feet away with one out here in the ninth. He sprayed it into shallow right, which was the best place he could have hit it. Dotel had to come in. Perez never slowed down. And Dotel's throw bounced away, backed up by the pitcher. They will intentionally walk Nash to load the bases. It'll be Paniagua coming up, and Polo's motioning, I believe, okay. He's motioning for Paniagua to come talk to him. Perez was a little bit banged up after that dive at third. I was afraid they were asking for Chong to come out. But, man, did Dre ever go in hard. And if not for Patterson, he may have jumped right to his feet and tried to score to win it. Big hit from Pounds. It then forces their hands to Walt Nash and load them. And now no room for error. That throwing error on Dotel, his second of the night, and Bridgeport's fourth error of the night. As they cue up Paniagua's intro again after that visit at the mound from manager Ricky Van Asselberg. Here's Paniagua, who's 1-for-3. A double and a run scored, also a walk. Bluefish set up to turn two on a grounder, and if they can't, the game could end. First pitch, swung on and hit high and deep. Left field, it's a game-winning grand slam home run! Salvador Paniagua out over the arch nemesis, and this one ends the night 10-6 as he runs into the mob scene at home plate. A walk-off grand slam, they tackle him to the ground, and Paniagua with his third home run of this homestand. Tackled at home plate, he ends it in dramatic fashion on the first pitch. The Revs with their fourth home run of the night. And all of them launched out to left field by right-hand bats. Ferdinand tied it in the eighth. Paniagua wins it in the ninth. On the second walk-off grand slam in Revs history. There was no doubt about it. Singles by Perez and Pounds set the table. And after they chose to not face Nash, Paniagua put on the display with the game-winning blast. Unbelievable. 10-6, the final score on the second walk-off grand slam in Revs history. And the first since P.J. Rose did it, down by 3 runs on July 11th, 2009, also against the Bluefish. The names have changed quite a bit since 09. But another walk-off grand slam, the second in the history of the franchise. Walk-off win number 10 of the season. And a game that featured a grand slam by both teams. It's Paniagua's who wins it. The Revs' fourth slam of the year, their third walk-off home run of the year, and the second walk-off slam in team history. What a night here at the bank. More history made, and Paniagua puts a capper on this one. 10-6, your final score. Stay tuned, post-game show follows next.